We love it when our viewers have great questions, and today we're going to tackle one that I think is an awesome one. Are you more closely related to Charlemagne or Julius Caesar? Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA. Be sure to subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to click on the bell if you want to be notified about upcoming episodes. I've told you in a previous video that everyone of European descent is related to Charlemagne, but very few of them actually share any DNA with Charlemagne. One of our viewers, Friedekin Bob, asked, are we more closely related to Charlemagne or to Julius Caesar? Now, this is an excellent question, and we can answer it in several different ways. Now, a little bit of history so that we're all on the same page. Charlemagne lived around 800 CE in Europe, and that would make him about our 40th great-grandfather. Julius Caesar, on the other hand, also lived in Europe, but about 50 BCE, and so that would make him about our 68th great-grandfather. So just on this basis alone, you would think that we must be more closely related to Charlemagne than we are to Julius Caesar. And from a genealogy standpoint, you'd be right because there's 28 generations between them. But this is a segment of DNA, and so we want to look at it from a DNA perspective. Now, if DNA was completely divisible, and if there was an unlimited number of people the further and further back in time you went, then we would still be more closely related to Charlemagne than we would be to Caesar. But DNA is not completely divisible, and there's not an unlimited number of people the further and further back in time you go. At 40 generations, you would have about 1 trillion 40th great grandparents. That's a lot. But at 68 generations, you would have almost 300 quintillion 68th great-grandparents, and that's a lot bigger number than 1 trillion. It would make for a really big family tree. But we know there hasn't even been that many humans that have ever lived, let alone the ones that are related to you. We all have pedigree collapse, where initially our tree starts to branch out and we get more and more people, but at some point, some of those people are the same, and our tree now may become a column, or even worse, it may start to collapse in on itself as we get to less and less people that we're related to in any one generation. You aren't related to as many people, but you're related to them in multiple ways. So if you have European ancestry, we can assume that you are related to all of the 30 million people that are alive at the time of Charlemagne. Now, this is actually a bad assumption, but it's a conservative assumption because you're actually related to less than them because some of those people didn't have any descendants. Now, those 30 million people are spread out over your 1 trillion spaces that you could have ancestors. And that means each one of them is going to show up about 33,000 times in your family tree. So if we still assume that DNA is completely divisible, then you're going to share 0.0002 centimorgans with each one of those 30 million people. And that means you shared that much DNA with Charlemagne. And that's the same as about 200 base pairs. And more than likely, there is at most one SNP in all of the DNA that you get from Charlemagne. And likely none at all. Now, it should be noted that this is so little DNA that none of the companies would ever be able to say that you have a match. So, even if we did have a sample of Charlemagne's DNA, other than on the Y chromosome, it's likely that no one alive today would register as a match to Charlemagne. But let's step back another 850 years to Julius Caesar. There were fewer people around in Europe, only about 20 million. Now, assuming that you're equally related to all of them, just like you were to Charlemagne and all the other Europeans, each of them are going to show up 15 trillion times in your family tree because you have 300 quintillion ancestors at that level. Now, since there are less people, lucky for us, that means you share more DNA with them. You share 0.0003 centimorgans with each one of them, and therefore with Julius Caesar. That's 300 base pairs, but it's still, at most, only one SNP, which again, is never going to be matched by any of the companies. So theoretically, you actually share more DNA with Julius Caesar than you do with Charlemagne. So you're more closely related genetically to Julius Caesar, who's 850 years older than Charlemagne. What's even more interesting to think about is because of the time scales involved and because of the populations involved, Charlemagne was also related to all 20 million of those people from Julius Caesar's time, which means you and Charlemagne are equally related genetically to Julius Caesar, even though you're 1,200 years younger than Charlemagne. But let's turn back to genealogy because these two people provide a great lesson in how we have relationships. You can't be descended from somebody who has no descendants. It's impossible. Charlemagne is known to have had at least 18 children, 11 of whom reached adulthood, and there's probably a lot more children that he did have that haven't been recorded. That guy got around. Now, those 11 children who reached adulthood also had multiple children and grandchildren themselves. And so you can see that this family line is propagated to the point that pretty much all the nobility of Europe in some way trace their ancestry back through Charlemagne. Now, statistically looking at it, let's go back, and Charlemagne should show up on our family tree 33,000 times at that 40th generation level. But if we go down a generation to the 39th generation, there's still about 30 million people in Europe. But each one of those is going to show up about 17,000 times in our family tree because there's half as many people in our family tree. But we know now that 11 of those people were children of Charlemagne. So instead of 33,000 potential paths to Charlemagne, we actually have 11 times 17,000 potential paths to Charlemagne, or 187,000. So because of the fact that Charlemagne had 11 children that reached adulthood that we know of, we've increased our chances of being related to him by a factor of 6. Julius Caesar, on the other hand, was not so prolific, according to historians. Besides his adopted children, Julius Caesar had 2 known natural children, Julia and Caesarion. Now, Caesarion was killed when he was just 17 years old, and there's no record of him having any children of his own. Julia, however, did live to adulthood, was married, and had a son. Unfortunately, she died during childbirth, and her son died a few days later. So there were no legitimate natural heirs of Julius Caesar, just his adopted heirs. Now, Julius Caesar also had several suspected illegitimate children. But even as I tracked down these illegitimate children, I couldn't find any evidence that they had children and grandchildren that would have then been able to propagate that line down through the ages. So it looks like Julius Caesar's biological descendants died with his grandson. No one alive today is a direct descendant of Julius Caesar. So even though genetically, we are statistically more likely to be related to Julius Caesar than we are to Charlemagne, because of the actual genealogy that we do have on both Julius Caesar and on Charlemagne, we can confidently say that we are more closely related to Charlemagne than we are to Julius Caesar, because Julius Caesar doesn't have any descendants alive today. So in 1,200 years, if you want everyone to be related to you, the best bet is to have a dozen kids. I'm going to take a guess that in 4000 CE, everyone on planet Earth is going to be descended from Maria, Benita Oliveira of Argentina, who in 1989 had her 32nd child, all of whom were reported as living at the time. If you have any questions about how you might be related to ancient people, put it in the comments below and I'll try to answer it. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and be sure to tell all your friends.